Outseal Arduino PLC programming. This is an introduction to Outseal PLC and Studio. We are going to set up circuit connections to test function blocks as we move along in this series. So let's get started. The Outseal PLC is an open source hardware that uses the Arduino bootloader. This means that the PLC could be made with an Arduino Uno or Nano. Programming of the PLC is done with ladder diagram in Outseal Studio. The software primary language is Indonesian, with the option for the English language. It supports I2C and SPI devices as well as Modbus communication. The ladder diagram can be simulated before uploading into the PLC. It can also be monitored online when in operation. There are two types of Outseal PLC: Outseal PLC Nano and Outseal PLC Mega. They are both compliant with the IEC 61131-2 standard, making them suitable for industrial application. The schematics for both PLC are freely available on the official website. Outseal PLC Nano has 8 syncing inputs with a voltage range of 10 to 30 VDC. Its 8 outputs can source current of up to 60 mA. Only 2 analog inputs are supported. It supports 1-channel high-speed counter and 1-channel pulse width modulation. The I2C and SPI communication protocols allow for the integration of expansion modules. The serial port is used for Modbus communication, which could also be over Bluetooth or Wi-Fi. Since the Outseal PLC Nano uses the same 80Mega328P microcontroller as the Arduino Nano, this tutorial series will use the Arduino Nano for demonstration. Digital inputs of the Outseal PLC Nano are mapped to the Arduino Nano from S.1 to S.8 as shown, while the digital outputs are mapped from R.1 to R.8. The analog inputs are A.1 and A.2. The UART and I2C ports are used as they are. To make the Arduino Nano function close to a commercial PLC, an external power supply of 24 volts will be required. A DC to DC step-down converter should bring down the voltage to between 6 to 12 volts and then fed to V-in of the Arduino Nano. The PC817 opto isolator module should be connected to the digital inputs of the Nano. Opto isolator relay module should go to the output of the Nano. Then 4 to 20 milliamp current to voltage converter model to the analog input for process transmitters. For today's demonstration, connect a push button switch to channel 1 of the PC817 opto isolator model, then to S.1 of the Arduino Nano. R.1 of the Nano to the relay model, then to an indicator lamp. Outseal Studio works with Arduino Nano version 3.0 that has the CH340 chip for USB communication. You can verify your Nano by looking out for the chip on its underside. If you don't already have the CH34G driver installed on your computer, you can download it and install it from the download page of outseal.com or from the official site with the link in the description. Connect the Arduino Nano to the USB port of your computer and verify the port number of the Nano from the device manager. Now, download Outseal Studio from the download page. Follow through the installation steps to install it. Check Launch Outseal Studio, then click on Finish to launch it. Let's now create a simple program to verify the installations. First, select English from the language option if you cannot read Indonesia. Then select Settings. Choose Nano V5 as the hardware, the port number, and then exit settings. Right-click on the horizontal line in the middle of the software and drag normally open contact with the left button of the mouse. Drop it on the red dot that appears on the horizontal line. Double-click on the normally open contact and type S.1. Follow similar steps to drop a normal coil on the line. Double-click on it and type arrow.1. Click on the PC to PLC send icon to upload the ladder diagram into the Nano. Holding down the push button switch connected to S.1 of the PLC should turn on the indicator lamp connected to arrow.1. With this, we can now explore the programming of Arduino Nano with Outseal Studio. Thanks for watching. Hit the like button if this video is helpful, and drop your thoughts in the comment section. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button if you are new to this channel, and the bell next to it. See you in the next video.